Hey guys, it's Cylone. I'm back. Yeah, I'm sorry I haven't been on at all. I've been distracted by school and papers. And no, I did not give up on Mario, even though it does piss me off a lot. I did not give up on it. And there is one more episode, but I completely forgot to post it after episode 4, and so now there's like a giant gap. But that one will be continued. Yeah, I'm sorry. It's close to final, so I haven't had time to do any recording. But I have been able to do a little bit of building on Minecraft because I've been using the World Painter, and that's pretty fun. And with it, I created this one map, and I'll show you what I've done so far with it. But the map I created is a crater. All right, and now, if you look at the giant body of water on the right end of the crater, that is on the right hand side of it, that is swamp, and then there's a giant the water spot in the middle, and then there's also a tower on there, and I'll get to that eventually. But down in this southeastern corner with the river running through it with a waterfall, it's normal forest. And of course, behind me, and what I'll be showing you first, is there was a small clearing I had made, and in it I made a forest, and you could probably hear the animals in the barn that are right behind me, but I'll get to that soon. To my left is all that dark green stuff is jungle, and there, of course, are like three small lakes. Two of them are connected, and then north is grasslands, just giant grasslands with a nice lake. And I'm planning on building... Alright, if you see that, like, plus sign in the grasslands near the, eastern lake, that's the town square of my second town I'm working on. And north of the small lake in the grasslands, I haven't started yet, but I'm planning on a medieval-style, city. And the small one where the plus is, that's gonna be like a town. And there'll be a gravel trail going from the town to the city. Oh, hey, it's dark. There'll be like a gravel road leading from the city to the town. But from the town here, they'll be going by water. And I've been trying to keep this as RP as possible. Like, the buildings I've been building, I've been trying to keep them to whatever resources are available. Like, if there's clay, I can use brick. If I make a little mine, I could use stone. And then, of course, depending on where I am, depends on the type of trees I use. Like, there aren't any pine trees used in the town, little village behind me. And enough of my blabbering, I'm going to show you the village now. And the first part is this little farm. This is the very first thing I built, and I only had some cows, but I went ahead and popped in some chickens and sheep. And over here, I made a small wheat farm with watermelon. And, of course, I went, like... This village doesn't really have a lot of iron, so it's not like they could just bucket water over to the farm. So what I did is I made a path from the river to the animals. That way they got a source of water. Alright. And next, I built the farm goods. This little shack carries all the goods for the farm. The tools. Whoa, I have lava in my... Oops. There we go. I have lava in my inventory. Okay, but yeah, tools, and this is the wheat watermelon. Like, I went ahead and stocked everything. But yeah, animal resources, because there's cows, chickens, and sheep, but there's no pig. Like, there was pig, but I got rid of them because the other village has a big resource of pig. And then here is the sugar cane that I have out there, the apples from the tree, and then the products of sugar cane. Like, I'm trying to keep this as, like, RP realistic as possible. And this building design is not my own. I got this building design from JamziboyMinecraft. I'm sure you might have heard of him. If not, look him up. He's a really great architect with Minecraft. And next building is the farmer's house, which is also a JamziBoy design. Only he has the thatch texture for his roofs. And also, these two buildings I copied, like, exactly. Like, all the other buildings I've ever made, one, I took his idea and I turned it, and like I made my own buildings out of it. But with this, I have tables, a chair, bookshelves, a chest for the goods. There's nothing in it. Toolbox, a dresser. I like this design. Props to JamziBoy for that. The fireplace, and behind that fire is the furnace. because I wanted to be like, hey, they should be able to cook stuff, but why the heck would they have a fire if they can't cook with it? So I went ahead and put the furnace behind it, so it seemed like they were cooking. And a double bed for two people to live in. All right, the third building I built is the woodcutter's house. Like, what I did is I kind of took that design a little bit, and I brought out the door, and I also did some other stuff. Now, this right here, these three simple blocks, it took me forever to try to pick a design, and I still don't think that's a good design, but that's the best I could think of for right there because of how it's shaped. But what I did for the woodcutter is the customers will come in here and ask for wood, and of course the woodcutter will be in. He'll be like, yeah, sure. And on his side, he has his chest of wood and his axes and all the different type of wood products like bookshelves, crafting tables, chests, sticks, trapdoors, all that stuff. And of course, the reason it's down there surrounded by wood is because that way people can't just come in, grab, and ditch. Like, it's a challenge to be able to get it, like, from jumping. But yeah, he has a small dresser, small table, and a bed for just one. And he also has the same furnace behind fireplace design that I did. Alright. Okay, I'll get to that first, but soon. But after that, I built the dock. And the dock, I have boats, and I did, like, the upside down half blocks to, that way it's above the water, or slightly above it. And I have the boats here. And the reason I have this dock is that way they can do trade by water, because the forest is really dense. I'll get to the waterfall, because I had to build the waterfall myself, and it was a bitch. But yeah, right here is the fisherman's cottage. I kind of took the design of the dome one, but I modified it a good bit. And inside, he has a gravel floor. He has a subtle lifestyle. The center chimney, double bed for him and his wife, and his fishing rods and his catch. So there's his house. Next, and was a big project, and I'm getting into the town square, and here's two flower beds right in front of the mayor's house. It looks kind of like a barn to me. Like, I'm kind of upset with how the shape came, but I do like the inside. And why okay, I also have a problem with the fireplace liking to burn down some of the wood. But inside, the mayor has a nice wide table, the furnace, fireplace as well. Then you come upstairs, he has a second fireplace, a destroyed freaking dresser that can't stay together, because it's a stupid, okay, and his bed for him and his wife, bookshelf, and his couch to look out upon his town, and I'll get to the building soon. What I also did with the mayor is, if I go down to the cellar, I like kind of how the cellar went, we have the town, the village's gold, which I kind of want to get rid of because this village seems more like a bartering type village, and also reserves of food and water. But also, you see this nice wine cellar thing? There's a missing block. You get up here. Oh ho! What is this? A hidden chest with the family sword, his armor, and a map of the world. And I'm planning on every major, like the major, the rulers of each city and the wizard tower, which I'll get to, have their own map of the island. Everyone else is kind of tough titties for them. But yeah, anyway, after that I did more work on this. I'll talk about the tavern last, not next, because that's not what I did next. But yeah, I made benches and I made my fountain. I like how the fountain turned out. But next, I just made a small simple house for villagers. Blank's house, because there's no one living here. And it's kind of like the farmer's house, but I kind of changed it a bit. Like, I moved the it's smaller. It's using birch tree planks, and the fireplace is off-centered. And it has a one-person bench. It's a one-person house. It's got a nice dresser, and of course, this chest of goods. Next is the tavern. It had, when I first built it, it had a